Welcome back to Checkpoint. So tonight our number comes a little bit earlier, and that's because it relates directly to the conversation we're about to have. If you recall, a couple of weeks ago, there was a conference to bring together women from across the political divide to try and shore up those numbers and encourage fellow women in terms of some of those numbers that we see in Parliament and to encourage their participation in elective politics. But so just how are we doing with this one? Let's take a look at our number for the week tonight. Look at this number. Since 1963, that's independence, up until 2012, before our last general election, just 50 women were elected between 1963 and the year 2012. This compares to about 1,806 men. So you can take a look at that number, it doesn't fare too well. So this is from independence up until before the last general election. So if we take a look at that last one, that was in 2013, we had just 16 women elected to parliament in that election. And then, of course, that was added up to the 47 women county reps in 2013. That is as per the new constitution. So if you take a look at that number, 16, 47, and then if you want to take a look at the county level, there was just 82 women that were elected as county reps in the year 2013. This is, of course, nothing compared to the number of men that were elected. If you want to take a look at these numbers further before we begin our conversation in just a short while, we had no woman that was elected as governor. And in fact, we had no woman elected as senators, even though we had some of them nominated. So these are just some of the numbers we're taking a look at with respect to elected members of parliament or at the various levels of representation. So if you take a look at the percentages, the National Assembly comprises just 19% of women and 81% of men. This is despite attempts to have the two-thirds gender rule implemented. We know what has happened with that. We've discussed that on Checkpoint, actually, once before. So how do we get these numbers up? And why is it important to have these numbers at a higher rate? Let's have a look at our discussion tonight. And